Hello, this is the next video on the MK2. Today I want to load up a new kernel ROM. So the first thing that you need to have to load up a new kernel ROM is a new kernel ROM. And since in this video we don't want to write one from scratch, we will just load down the original kernel ROM and modify it and load it up again. By loading down, I'm not talking about loading it down from the internet or something else, because you already have a specially for you licensed one on the MK2. So you just load it from there, modify it and load it back. For loading it down, I have written a small program. It does not really much, as you see here. It's just saving the kernel. So it's saving the memory from the area where the kernel is located. I also will provide this program to you so that you can download your kernel from your MK2. So now let's do this. So you see here the program that I've showed before and that I will also provide. So now just let's load and execute it. So now it's saving again the kernel on the disk, on exactly the same disk that you used to provide this the saving program to. So I will put this on fast forward. Okay. So and now if you have a look again on the on the disk. So now here is the kernel. So now the next thing is somehow to bring this kernel to your PC or wherever. You can edit it with an hex file editor. So what I used to open it on the PC is this Notepad++. There is an extension where you can say view the file in a hex editor. I think it's an additional plugin, so you need to install it. And after this, you get this view, so you where you directly see the hex file. And now there are a few modifications you have to do. So first of all, I think maybe this could also be optimized by changing the download file. I don't know. So at the beginning, there are two additional bytes which are not necessary or which are even a problem if we load it up later. So we remove, them. Strange, I realized that I was able, So this is the first modification. Then the second modification, I'm also not sure why this happens. At the end, an FF is missing. So, and now we are coming to the modification itself. And what we do is at about 450, there starts the message that the Commodore uses when it starts up. So you see here, Commodore 64 basic F2. And now we just modify here and say, okay. So we want here to have an E-I-I space S space. It's important that you keep the same size of this or the same length of the string. So now let's save this. And now this is the file. It's already located on the PC that we now use to save or to load up to the MK2. Okay, so after connecting the MK2 with the USB to the PC, we just need the menu, and then we select the U to upload a ROM. We upload a custom ROM image 1. You also can choose any other. And then again, I think you cannot see it if I have it like this. But anyway, you have seen it in the last video. You just need now to select data, transfer, X modem, and send. Then you need to select the file which you have modified directly now. So in my case, this is on the desktop, and it is saved under kernel. And then it comes up with the message that the transfer is completed. So it's now the same as it was with the character ROM. It's not working directly right now. We need to let the MK2 know that it also should use now the uploaded ROM. So this is done by M, memory and ROM selection. So today we are going for selecting a kernel ROM, so it's K. And then you see it's actually using the default, and we want to use the custom kernel ROM, so it's 1. And then let's save this, X, let's save this by right settings. And anyway, it's saved. I have a little bit of problem with my WIC sometimes. So yeah, this WIC is very on the very edge. So, but anyway, now I've switched on, and what you see is the following. Yeah, and what you see is the following. You see now here another starting message as we have modified it in the kernel. Of course, this is only now an example to show a few things. I mean, changing the starting screen is not a big thing. But for example, what you could do is to change the startup sequence in order that it starts up with a color character ROM. And then in addition, also exchange the character ROM. And then you have completely different startup and feel, look and feel of your Commodore, for example. What you could do, or what for example often is done, is that the loading and saving routines are changed to have fast load and so on. But this is the general workflow. So yeah, continue enjoying your MK2. Bye.